What makes a movie good or great? What are the attributes we should base our judgment on? The characters? The emotional core? Yes, but there's something more important than those. And that is the flow of logic. The word logical doesn't necessarily mean realistic. If a movie is based on our reality, it has to be realistic. If a movie has magical elements, it has to follow those specific magical rules. Now, when a moment within the movie contradicts any pre-established rule of the movie or the universe the movie sets in, it makes the logical error or breaks the flow of logic. A scene can tamper with logic on the surface level, like breaking into a song or using any other visual gag, but the story underneath has to have a logical structure. It's one thing to debate whether a scene or a plot was logical or not, but a lot of people online are questioning if logic should at all be brought up while discussing a movie. The opposition believes it's the characters or the emotional moments that makes or breaks a film, not the flow of logic. This would make sense if the flow of logic had nothing to do with well-written characters or well-written emotional moments. In fact, I find them inseparable. A story or a script is a collection of information built on one another. A character is a part of that information regarding his personality, identity, actions, etc. When these information naturally leads the character from one part of his journey to another, the character writing maintains the flow of logic. The characters themselves don't have to be the most rational people, but the reason behind their action has to have a logical connection with the information provided. We call these characters consistent characters. And consistent here doesn't mean predictable, because there are a lot of directions these characters can be taken to. The character writing devoid of logic creates an inconsistent character. What's the point of knowing such character? These information won't be respected going forward. One of the most well-noted character traits of Harry Potter is that he is brave. Sometimes he may have a hard time to act brave. When someone is in danger, he always musters up courage to save that person. Imagine in a future sequel, we see him abandoning someone in danger because he didn't have enough courage. It wouldn't matter if that's what most people on Earth would do, because Harry wouldn't. The only way to justify this scene is to show events in between that naturally pushed him in this specific direction. Let's say the character writing is fine, but the rest of the narrative is flawed. The rest of the narrative is supposed to provide challenges for the characters to show their strengths, weaknesses, and to grow. If these challenges aren't logical, they're underwhelming. The reason we fear the stakes or feel any other genuine emotion, though we know nothing we see in a movie is real, is that subconsciously we submerge ourselves into these fake worlds. Again, it doesn't necessarily have to be realistic. If imaginative stories follow their own rules and develop logically, it's enough for us to feel real emotion. The stronger the logical bond, the stronger the submersion, and the harder the emotion hits. The more it contradicts itself, the more questions we form in our mind, and these questions take us out of the movie. Now let's imagine a movie. A bunch of farmers in a village are doing well for themselves, until a herd of pigs starts to invade and keep destroying the crops. The farmers then start crying and abandon farming altogether. Are you going to feel sorry for them? Or ask questions like, why can't they build a fence or chase the pigs away? Anything that any other normal human beings would do. Let's imagine another movie where farmers build a fence and win the day. But it was previously established in that movie that pigs in that world can fly. Are you going to feel triumphant? Or you're going to question, why would this work? Now, these plot holes are too big to miss. But even when they are small, they do hurt the submersion after we put some thought into it. A movie is not just for watching once. It's for watching once, twice, thrice. It's worth talking about, thinking about, and learning from. If it doesn't hold up after our eyes are taken off from it, then it's, you know, not a good movie. When people say the movie was logically flawed, but the character work and the emotional sentiments made up for it, They're basically saying there were something logically wrong, but things that it got logically right made up for it. The logical part being the character writings and the emotional investments. And if you're one of those people who thinks logic still doesn't matter, the movie you like it, then it says more about you. You're amazing. But the movie you like might still be bad. A movie being good or bad is a totally different conversation from a movie being liked or disliked. There's a notion that art is subjective? No. An opinion based on personal preferences is a subjective opinion, and an opinion devoid of personal preferences is an objective one. And here's the thing, objective opinions are not facts. We would have different opinions. Some of us would be wrong and some of us would be right. We can all have friendly debates until we get some sort of closure. This is what happens in every other field. Scholars propose various opinions and they debate over them for decades, if not centuries. And that's how science evolves. Though art is a bit ambiguous, you can have an objective opinion on an art. If I can say I don't like this movie because it's long, that says no fault of the movie. A movie can be long or short depending what type of movie it needs to be. That says more about what I personally prefer. But if I say the movie was longer than it needed to be, whether I prefer a long movie or not, the movie wastes time and it needs to be shrunken down. Again, it doesn't mean I can't be wrong. Someone can correct me, pointing out why something I signed off as unnecessary actually needed. There are movies I like, I don't consider them flawless. There are some I know is brilliant, but I don't like them. So I find both subjective and objective views interesting. Sometimes I want to know how different people feel about a movie, and sometimes I want to know how good or bad the movie actually is. Now let's imagine another movie. There are a bunch of farmers in the village. They see some pigs invading their crops. They immediately run and chase them away, build some fences, save the day. The end. No plot holes.
Are you not entertained?
Now, there's one thing that is slightly more important than the flow of logic, and that is creativity. I'd rather watch something creative that made some mistakes than watch something that didn't try anything new to have made any mistakes. Contrary to popular belief, logic doesn't stand on the way of creative storytelling. Someone can come up with creative ideas and support these ideas with logical structures. Imaginative movies make their own logic. All they have to do is follow them. There are movies that deliberately breaks logic for comedy or metaphors or some visual gags. The logical thing to do there is to be logical, because that's the point. The viewers are supposed to notice the break of logic. And then there are some other movies that break logic because the illogical scenario is a little more fun. Like shooters never running out of bullets, characters not dying after being shot a million times, the absence of physics in fight scenes, and inhuman strength in human. These creative decisions should weigh out the need for logical perfection first. The flow of logic should be set as a high bar before any random thing gets in the script. This is what sets apart a good writer from anyone else. Anyone can write something creative out of their heads. A child can do that. But only a great writer can write a creative scenario along with the logical structure. Agree? Disagree? Let me know. Like if you like, share if you like, subscribe if you like.